রাহুল বলেন
গুড আফটারনুন স্যার।
হ্যাঁ গুড আফটারনুন, গুড আফটারনুন। হ্যালো, গুড আফটারনুন অল অফ ইউ। হ্যালো,
Yes, sir, it is audible.
ইট ইজ অডিবল না টু অল? ইট ইজ অডিবল না?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
সো ওয়ার ইউ স্টপ ইন দ্য লাস্ট ক্লাসেস স্টুডেন্টস? এনিওয়ান ক্যান টোল মি দ্যাট, ওয়ার ইউ স্টপ ইন দ্য লাস্ট ক্লাসেস?
Sir, today we will start welding.
Welding is not start last class.
No, sir. Sir, only sir has shown the equipments of welding.
But we are not discuss about the welding. What is
No,
welding
sir.
and
Sir,
what are the
sir,
types of welding?
sir, discuss हुआ था गैस वेल्डिंग तक आप बोले थे।
वो गैस वेल्डिंग तक बोले थे ना?
Yes, sir.
ओके ठीक। सो गैस वेल्डिंग ये हो गया था। गैस वेल्डिंग इज इट डन बाय द बर्न? ऑल ऑफ यू राइट ना? Anyone can show the copies? Anyone can show the copy? Anyone? Hello, anyone can show your copy? Kanchan sir,
Yes, sir.
okay,
Yes, sir.
okay, okay, you can show it. Oh, gas holding is complete, na? I just wait. Okay, that is okay. So write please, all of you write please. Hello, hello.
Yes, sir.
Oxyacetylene welding. OXY. Oxy. Please write please. And acetylene is a one of the gas which will be used for the welding. So oxyacetylene. Right, please. O X Y. Oxy. A C E. Hyphen deke. Hyphen deke. A C E T Y L E N E. Oxyacetylene welding. Okay. Oxyacetylene gas welding. Right, please. Oxyacetylene gas welding is used. Oxyacetylene gas welding is used. By melting melting, melting the edges, edges, edges or surface, melting the edges or surface to be joined, surface to be joined by gas flame, surface to be joined by gas flame, by gas flame, FLAME flame. And allowing allowing the metal molten metal molten metal allowing the molten metal to flow together.
Sir, repeat from starting.
Okay. Okay. I can repeat it. Oxyacetylene gas welding. It is very important. You can write. All of you have write. Oxyacetylene gas welding is used by melting the edges edges or surface to be joined by gas flame and allowing the molten metal to flow together flow together thus forming a solid continuous joint continuous joint after cooling. Solid continuous joint, joint, joint after cooling, COOLING, cooling. This process is particularly this process full stop. This process is particularly PRTICULARLY, particularly suitable for joining metal sheet. Suitable for joining metal sheet, SHWTS sheets and plates, PLATS plates, having thickness of 2 to 50 millimeter, thickness of 2 to 50 millimeter, full stop. With material thicker than 15 millimeter, with material, MATRIL, material thicker, THICKA, thicker than 15 millimeter, additional metal called filler metal is very important. Filler metal, FILLER, filler metal, METL metal is added. That means when you have to join more than 15 millimeter, okay, you have to add it. One metal that is called as a filler metal added to the plate after with joining the oxyacetylene welding. Okay, when joining by oxyacetylene welding with material thicker than 15 millimeter, additional metal called filler metal is added to the weld in the form of welding rod. Full stop. The composition of the filler rod is usually USUALY, usually the same or nearly the same. I told you again, the composition of the filler rod is usually the same or nearly the same as that of the part PRT being welded, WELDAD, welded, full stop. To remove the impurities and oxidize present on the surface of the metal to be joined and to obtain a satisfactory bond a flux is always employed. A flux, FLUX, flux. This is one of the word is very important for welding systems. The flux.
Sir, after is, and to obtain.
Okay, I told you that. To remove the impurities and oxidize present on the surface of the metal to be joined, SATISFACTORI, satisfactory bond, BOND, bond means joining between the two bodies, bond, a flux is always employed, EMPLOID employed, during the welding, except mild steel, which has more manganese and silica, which has more manganese and silicon that act as a deoxidizing agent. Okay, full stop. I just show you that one thing. Okay, I just take the first pin. Okay. So this is the body you have joined. My screen is here to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that is okay. So this is the body we have joined. This is our welding rod. This torch. Okay. This is actually basically called as the inner core. I told you the letter inner core. I-N-N-E-R. Inner N. This is actually basically called as the inner core. This is the direction of welding. This is the direction of welding. This is our base metal. Base metal. Okay. So this is the welding process. Okay, this is the base metal actually. This one is the base metal. This one. And this is the molten metal. Molten metal. This is the molten part of this part. I just show you that color. This is actually basically, this is the molten part. This part is molten part, and this is the base metal which will be have. So this is the welding process, general welding process. Okay. This is the welding rod, and this is the torch which will be have coming out the oxyacetylene, and oxyacetylene is mixed here, and we have a form as a heating of this particular points, and welding rod which will be provided here, and the joint between these two body here it is actually called. Okay, I'll tell you the next. Now right, please, full stop. Various gas combination to be used for producing a hot flame for welding metals, full stop. The common mixture of gases is oxygen and acetylene. Is oxygen, oxygen, oxygen and acetylene, acetylene, oxygen and acetylene, comma, oxygen and hydrogen, 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 comma, oxygen and other flue gases, and last one, and air and acetylene. And the last one is, there are so many actually gas welding gas process which will we have to combine to each other. So that is, first is called as a oxygen acetylene, second is oxygen hydrogen, third one is oxygen and other flue gases, and last one is air and acetylene. The oxygen, full stop. The oxygen acetylene mixture is used. The oxygen acetylene mixture is used to a much greater, than the other. And the other. Okay. Full stop. Now write, please. Second point. Gas flame. GAS, gas flame. FLAME, flame. Gas flame. Full stop. Right, please. Gas flame. The correct adjustment of the flame. Anyone can have. Okay. So the correct adjustment of the flame is important for reliable welding work. The correct adjustment of the flame is important for reliable welding work. Full stop. When oxygen and acetylene are supplied to torch, this is the torch which actually I draw here. When oxygen and acetylene are supplied to torch, TORCH torch, in nearly equal volume, a neutral flame is produced. NEUTRAL, neutral flame is produced. That means the mixture of oxygen and acetylene, if the volume of the mixture of these two particular gases are same, then the flame which will be produced, which will be have a, called as a neutral flame. Okay. So when I told you that when oxygen and acetylene are supplied to torch in nearly equal volume, a neutral flame is produced. Okay. Clear, all of you? That when the volume of the gases between these two gases are same, then the flame which will be produced after the burning of these two gases, which will be have called as a neutral flame. Okay. Full stop. The heat is generated in accordance with a pair of chemical reaction. That means heat which will be generated between the chemical reaction between the two gases. Okay. Full stop. The primary reaction occur at the inner core. The primary reaction occur at the inner core. The primary, again I told you that, the primary reaction occur at the inner core, where the temperature reaches in between, where the temperature reaches in between 3050 to 3450 degrees Celsius. This is very important. In a oxyacetylene gas welding, the neutral flame, when it produces a neutral flame, the inner core temperature is between 3050 to 3450 degrees Celsius. Okay? Clear, all of you? When it, again, I told you that when the two gases are combined, when two gases are reacting to each other as a volume, then if it is the volume which will be have equal, that is the equally volume which will be have the two cases are mixed to each other, the flame which will be produced is called as a neutral flame. And that when it is the neutral flame, then inner core of the temperature of this particular neutral flame is between 3050 to 3450 degrees Celsius. Okay? Clear? Full stop. The secondary combustion process, the secondary, this is the primary combustion, okay, the primary reaction process, this is called as a primary combustion process. The secondary, full stop, the secondary combustion process is in the outer envelope, that is the outer core, okay. The secondary combustion process is in the outer envelope in which, the flame attained a temperature around 2100 degrees Celsius. Attained the temperature around 2000 100 degrees Celsius near the inner core. Near the inner core. Near the inner core. That means the outer boundary of the inner core. Basically, it is the outer boundary of the inner core, which will be the temperature is around 2100 degrees Celsius. And and around 1250 degrees Celsius and 1250 degrees Celsius, that means 1250 degrees Celsius at the end point of the flame. At the end point of the flame. Okay, full stop. The temperature develop in the flame, the temperature develop in the flame as a result of this reaction, the temperature develop is around, in the flame is around 3200 degrees Celsius to 3300 degrees Celsius. Full stop. This neutral flame is applicable. This neutral flame is applicable for most welding operation. Is applicable for most welding operation. But in certain cases, a slightly oxidizing flame, oxidizing, oxidizing flame. In certain cases, a slightly oxidizing flame, in which, that means we are considering as a oxidizing flame, in which there is an excess of oxygen. In which there is an excess of oxygen. That means in a volume, when you mix, is the oxygen volume is more as compared to the acetylene, then the flame which will be generated is called as an oxidizing flame. Okay. Or slightly carburizing flame, CARBURIZING, carburizing flame, in which there is an excess of acetylene is, in which there is an excess of acetylene. Full stop. Now, a neutral flame, I can first draw this one. All of you visible to my screen? Yes?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Neutral flame. Actually, this is the mouse, is very difficult to write. Neutral flame. This is the torch. This is called torch. This is the torch tip. This is the torch tip. This is inner core. It is actually basically called inner core. The temperature is around 3200 degrees Celsius. and the out, this is the outer envelopes of this particular inner core, that is called as a 1100 degree Celsius, and the tip of that, this is the tip which will be called, this is tip, the temperature is 1250 degree Celsius. Okay, so write please, full stop. A neutral flame has two definite zones. A neutral flame has two definite zones, Z-O-N-E-S, zones. A neutral flame has two definite zones. One, a sharp cone, sharp, S-H-A-R-P, sharp cone, C-O-N-E, cone, extending a short distance from the tip of the torch, extending a short distance from the tip of the torch. Okay, a sharp cone, this is the tip of the torch. Okay, and second one, the outer cone or envelope, this is the envelope or outer cone, this is called as the envelope. Second, this is called as the envelope. The outer cone or envelope only envelope only luminous, L-U-A-M-I-N-O-U-S, luminous and of a bluish color, blue, B-L-U-I-S-H, bluish color, and of a bluish color, full stop. The first one develop heat and the second protect the molten metal, and the second protect the molten metal from oxidization, and the second protect the molten metal from the oxidization, because the oxygen in the surrounding atmosphere, because the oxygen in the surrounding atmosphere is consumed, C-O-N-S-U-M-E-D, consumed by the gases from the flame, consumed by the gases from the flame. Full stop. The neutral flame is widely used for welding steel, stainless steel, cast iron, copper, aluminium, copper, C-O-P-P-E-R, copper, aluminium, A-L-U-A-L-U-M-I-N-I-U-M, aluminium, etc. Okay, next. Oxidizing flame. Oxidizing flame. Okay, AME. An oxidizing flame, right, please. An oxidizing flame, OXIDIZING, I think. Oxidizing. SING or ZING? Something should write as a SING or something as a ZING. Okay. So, oxidizing flame is one in which there is an excess of oxygen. Oxidizing flame is one in which there is an excess of oxygen. There is an excess of oxygen. This flame is also has, this flame is also has two zones. One, the smaller inner core, which has purplish tinges, purplisha, purplish tinges, tinges, tinges. And the second one, that is outer core or envelope.
So repeat once.
The smaller one, switch up. The smaller one, that is the, sorry, in a one inner core, which has the inner core, which has purplished tinges. This is actually basically purple shape, purplished thing, purplisha. Purplish tinges, tinges, tinges. And the outer core and the outer cone or envelope, the outer cone or envelope, full stop. In the case of oxidizing flame, the inner core is not sharply defined. In case of oxidizing flame, the inner core is not sharply, sharply, sharply defined. In case of oxidizing flame, the inner core is not sharply defined as that of neutral flame. Full stop. This flame is necessary for welding brass. Brass. Full stop. In steel, this will result in a large gain size. Comma, increase brittleness. With low strength and elongation. Due to this excess oxygen in the oxidizing flame, results in high temperature up to 3400 degrees Celsius. This is centigrade of that particular. Okay. Now, carburizing flame. Now, this is carburizing thing. Carburizing flame. Okay. This is carburizing flame. Now, right click. A carburizing flame is one. A carburizing flame is one in which there is an excess of acetylene. A carburizing flame is one in which there is an excess of acetylene, A-C-E-T-Y-L-E-N-E, acetylene. In this flame, there are three zones. One, the sharply defined inner cone. Second one, an intermediate cone of whitish color, whitish color. An intermediate cone of whitish color. And the third, the bluish outer cone. And the third, the bluish outer cone. The length, full stop. All of you right? Full stop. The length of the intermediate cone is the indication of the properties of excess acetylene in the flame. The length of the intermediate cone, that means if you have see that one of the intermediate cone is present, then you have identified that this flame, which will be called as a carburizing flame. Okay. The length of the intermediate cone is an indication of the properties of excess acetylene in the flame. When welding steel, this will tends to give the steel in the weld a higher carbon content. The higher carbon content than the parent metal. Therefore, resulting in a hard and brittle weld. Brittle weld. Due to this excess acetylene in the carburizing flame, the result temperature is around 2000 degrees Celsius to 2700 degrees Celsius, 2000 degrees centigrade to 2700 degrees centigrade. Full stop. Okay, all of you clear? What are the three different flames which will be generated when according to the when the excess of volume which will be increased in the oxygen or acetylene, or if you have a volume which will be have to both are the same. If you have a both the volumes which will be same, then you will come that the flame which will be generated is called as a neutral flame. If you have the increase the oxygen volume, then it is the flame which will be generated is called as a oxidizing flame. And if you have increased the acetylene, then it's called as a carburizing flame. Okay. So the when the changes the oxygen and the acetylene, the temperature of the core which will be have changes. Okay. That means according to your requirement, whatever which material you have to join it, you according to that you can increase oxygen or acetylene, or you have to volume which will be same for the neutral flame also. Okay. Now gas welding technique. Next, right, please. Gas welding technique. TECHNIQUE. Gas welding technique. According to the position of welding, all oils are classified one downhand or flat downhand or flat oils deposited in any direction on an horizontal surface, so that the flame is above the face of the weld, above the face of the weld. I just draw it. Okay. Okay, so this is actually basically the horizontal oil. Okay, this is called as horizontal directions. Okay, so that means that when the oil deposited in a direction on a horizontal surface, so that the flame is above the face of the oil, is called as a downhand or flat oils. Okay, and next one, second one, vertical oils. Deposited on a vertical surface in a vertical direction, that is upward or downward. Vertical oils deposited on a vertical surface in a vertical direction, that is upward or downward. I can draw this one. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Hello. Okay, I can repeat it. I just first draw it. Okay, so this is actually basically called as a vertical well. So from starting from here to here, and from here to here. Okay, so that is called as a vertical well. That is vertical wells deposited on a vertical surface. Vertical well deposited on a vertical surface in the vertical direction. Vertical wells deposited on a vertical surface in a vertical direction, that is upward or downward. If you have this one, which will be have from downward to upward, the boiling will be start from the downward and goes to up to the upward. Okay, or you have starting from upward and goes to the downward. So this is the process which will be called as a vertical welding system. Okay, now inclined weld, third one. Inclined welds deposited up or down on an inclined surface. Inclined welds deposited up or down on an inclined surface. Up and down on an inclined surface. Okay, I can draw it. Okay, so this is actually basically called as a inclined weld. This is welding. So starting from here to here and again it goes from here to here. So that means from starting from here and come to the end of this particular body. The plate which will be have some inclination, which will be called as a inclined weld. The weld is not the inclination. There is sometimes the weld is also come have an inclination which will be provided, but it is not possible. But the body which will be have inclination, some which will be called the inclined welds deposited up and down on inclined surface. So that is called as a inclined weld. Okay. Now next one. Horizontal weld deposited on a vertical surface in an horizontal direction. Horizontal welds deposited on a vertical surface. Horizontal weld deposited on a vertical surface in an horizontal direction. Horizontal weld deposited on a vertical surface in an horizontal direction from left to right or from right to left. Left to right or right to left. So these cases, this one. Here, So from here to here, I just change the color. And from here to here. Okay. From here to here. Okay. Hello, Ritik. হ্যাঁ, আমি একটু সে ক্লাস নিলাম, ধরে ধরে বাদ ফোন করো, আধা ঘন্টা বাদ। ওকে, হ্যাঁ ঠিক। সো দ্যাট ইজ অ্যাকচুয়ালি কল্ড অ্যাজ এ হরিজেন্টাল ওয়েল ডিপোজিটেড অন এ ভার্টিক্যাল সার্ফেস। দিস ইজ দ্য হরিজেন্টাল ওয়েল, দিস ইজ কল্ড অ্যাজ এ হরিজেন্টাল ওয়েল বাট ডিপোজিটেড অন এ ভার্টিক্যাল সার্ফেস ইন এন হরিজেন্টাল ডাইরেকশন। ওকে, সো ফ্রম লেফট টু রাইট অর ফ্রম রাইট টু লেফট, দিস ইজ ওয়ান অফ দ্য ওয়েল্ডিং সিস্টেম। নাও লাস্ট ওয়ান ইজ overheated oil, overhead, H-E-A-D, head, over, over, overhead oils, overhead oils deposited on a horizontal surface in any directions, deposited in a horizontal surface in any direction so that the face of the oil is above the flame, so that the face of the oil is above the flame. Okay. Full stop. Now next, in the next line, leftward or forward oiled, leftward, L-E-F-T, leftward, W-R-D, word or forward welding, leftward or forward welding, F-O-R-W-A-R-D, forward welding, leftward, L-E-F-T, leftward, W-R-D, word or forward welding. Okay. The welding is made. The welding is made working from left to right. The welding is made working from left to right. The welding is made working from left to right. Full stop. I just draw first, okay. All of you visible the skin?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I can draw it first. Okay. This is the torch, okay. So this is basically angle is 40 degrees, and this angle sixty to 70 degrees, and this is the process of this part which will be have welded. Okay. So right, please. The blowpipe, B-L-O-W, blowpipe is held in the right hand. So this part which will be have in the right hand. Okay. And the welding rod is in the left hand. The welding rod is in the left hand. That means when you done in the gas welding, the welding rod is always hold in your left hand, and the blow pipe, which will be have a blow pipe or the torch, which will be hold in your right hand, and the, you have to do the welding process. So this is actually process of the gas welding. Okay, so the blow pipe is held in the right hand and the welding rod is in the left hand, full stop. The blow pipe should be given in a small, the blow pipe should be given a small sideway movement. The blow pipe should be given in a small sideway movement, and the rod, that is a welding rod, should be moved, and the welding rod should be moved slightly without sideway movement. Should be moved, and the welding rod should be moved steadily without sideway movement. Full stop. The head of the blow pipe is held, the head of the blow pipe, so this is the blow pipe, or you called it, this is the torch you also called it. The head of the blow pipe is held at an angle of, held at an angle of between 60 to 70 degree to the plane of the weld, to the plane of the weld. One hold it, someone. I'm going to class next class for a phone coach. To be held, the head of the blow pipe is held at an angle of between 60 to 70 degree. So this angle is between 60 to 70 degree to the plane of the weld. So this is the plane of the weld. This is the weld. This is the plane of the weld. And the welding rod, and the welding rod, and the welding rod is around 30 to 40 degree. And the welding rod is around 30 to 40 degree. Full stop. The left hand method is most suitable on plates. The left hand method is most suitable on plates up to about 3 millimeter. And also for thicker plate. Now next one is rightward or backward welding. RIGHT, rightward, WRD, rightward or backward, BACK, backward, WRD word, welding, rightward or backward welding. In this welding process is carried out from left to right, and the rod following the blow pipe, I can draw it, okay? Same things, but there is a changes. Okay. So this is the process that you have to move from left to right. Okay. It has no lateral movement. So it has no lateral movement. The blowpipe should make an angle. It has no lateral movement. The blowpipe, full stop, the blowpipe should make an angle of about, the blowpipe should make an angle of about 40 to 50 degree with the plane of the plate. With the plane of the plate. This is the plane of the plate. Okay. This is the plane of the plate. This is the plane of the plate. Okay. And the welding rod, this one. Okay. And the welding rod should be an angle between 30 to 40 degree, and the welding rod should be angle between 30 to 40 degree. Okay. The angle of blowpipe is 10 to 20 degree. The angle of blowpipe is 10 to 20 degree greater than the leftward welding. The angle of blowpipe full stop. The edge is in right hand welding, rightward welding. The edge is in rightward welding. The edges in rightward welding should be approximately 10 to 15 degree less than the leftward welding. The edges in rightward welding should be approximately 10 to 15 degree less than the leftward welding. The welding speed is about 20 to 25%. The welding speed is about 20 to 25% higher than leftward welding, and the fuel consumption is around 15 to 20% and the 15 to 20% higher than the leftward welding. Okay. So this is all about our welding techniques. Now we can stop. I can file set. Hi, sir. Hello. Anyone, any questions about that? Anyone, any doubt about the oxyacetylene welding?
Yes, sir.
Kya karaoge? Uske welding ka oxyacetylene welding aaj kara do. Next day gas welding kara dete hain. Aaj oxyacetylene kara do. आर्क वेल्डिंग कराते
हैं। आर्क वेल्डिंग।
हाँ, नेक्स्ट क्लास में आर्क वेल्डिंग कराएंगे। आज गैस वेल्डिंग करा दीजिए।
अच्छा, ठीक है। ओके सर।
हाँ, ओके, ठीक। चलो, आई स्टॉप करता हूँ शेयरिंग। हाँ।
ओके। थैंक यू। Hello student, today your job is gas welding. Okay. Previous class में तुम लोगों ने arc welding मैंने दिखाया था, तुम लोग arc welding का video तुम लोग देखा है, job complete हो गया है, almost done complete हो गया है. तो आज तुम लोग क्या करोगे, gas welding. तुम लोग को आज जो हम लोग job करेंगे gas welding का job है, ठीक है. Butt joint जो तुमने previous class में किया था, single V butt joint arc welding, उसी job को हम लोग करेंगे आज. Butt joint उसका thickness of plate 3 mm, वहाँ पे तुम लोग क्या रहते हैं, थिकनेस ऑफ प्लेट 6 mm. ओके, तो वन बाय वन मैं एक एक करके तुम लोग को गैस वेल्डिंग सेटअप में दिखा रहा हूँ. गैस वेल्डिंग सेटअप क्या क्या यहाँ यूज़ होता है सेटअप में. फर्स्ट वन इज सिलेंडर की. ओके, सिलेंडर की, देन सिलेंडर ऑक्सीजन सिलेंडर एंड एसिटिलिन सिलेंडर. एक्चुअली क्या है, ऑक्सी एसिटिलिन वेल्डिंग मीन्स ऑक्सीजन एंड एसिटिलिन. तो ये हमारा सिलेंडर जो है क्या है, ऑक्सीजन O2 एंड C2H2 मींस एसिटिलीन. एसिटिलीन को हम लोग क्या कहते हैं, DA सिलेंडर भी कहते हैं, ठीक है. मींस हेलो स्टूडेंट, हेलो.
यस सर.
हाँ, किसी ने चैट बॉक्स में ये तुम लोग कोई क्वेश्चन पूछे क्या अभी?
नहीं सर, ये कौन सर थे वो पता नहीं चला, इसीलिए पूछे थे कौन सर है.
अच्छा सर, तुम कौन बोल रहे हो?
सर सुमित है.
अच्छा सुमित, सुमित मीर आचार्य जी है ना. अच्छा अच्छा, वो
सर.
पहले जो सर बताया तुम लोगों को तो पता है, औसत माझी सर. ओके
अच्छा.
देन मैं इसके निजामुद्दीन, वो तुम लोग गैस वेल्डिंग का वो वीडियो में शेयर कर रहा. ओके
ओके सर.
एक्चुअली क्या होता है ना कि पहले हम लोग क्या करते हैं, वो आर्क वेल्डिंग पहले पहले होता है, देन गैस वेल्डिंग, ठीक है. क्योंकि बेसिक एक्चुअली आर्क वेल्डिंग है, अगर आर्क वेल्डिंग तुम नहीं कर पाओगे तो गैस वेल्डिंग थोड़ा टफ हो जाता है, ठीक है ना. ठीक है, तो ये मैं समझो, मैंने वो वहाँ प्रीवियस क्लास बोला, तो ये मैं समझो कि तुम्हारा आर्क वेल्डिंग कम्प्लीट हो गया, ठीक है.
जी सर, जी सर.
हाँ ठीक है, कॉन्फ्यूज मत होना. ठीक है, तो मैं इसको कंटिन्यू करता हूँ. बोले डिजॉल्व एसिटिलीन. ओके, नेक्स्ट सिलेंडर की. सिलेंडर की फर्स्ट वन सिलेंडर की, सेकेंड हो गया क्या, सिलेंडर एंड सिलेंडर बल्ब. ओके, देखो यहाँ पे एक सिलेंडर स्क्वायर शेप का एक बल्ब है, बोथ ऑक्सीजन एंड एसिटिलीन. ओके, तो इसको हम लोग क्या करेंगे, क्लोज, इसको ओपन एंड क्लोज करना है. तो हम लोग इसको क्लोज किधर करेंगे और ओपन किधर करेंगे, तो ये ओपन होगा एक्चुअली क्या, एंटी क्लॉक वाइज. ओके, बोथ सिलेंडर ऑक्सीजन एंड एसिटिलीन, ये एंटी क्लॉक वाइज में ओपन होगा एंड क्लॉक वाइज में ये क्लोज होगा. ओके, नेक्स्ट हो गया तो हम लोग का ये प्रेशर रेगुलेटर. ओके, ऑक्सीजन प्रेशर रेगुलेटर एंड एसिटिलीन प्रेशर रेगुलेटर. इसका देखो कलर है क्या, ऑक्सीजन प्रेशर रेगुलेटर का ब्लैक और ब्लू. ओके, एंड एसिटिलीन का प्रेशर रेगुलेटर का देखो उसका सिंबल क्या है, रेड. ओके, एक्चुअली क्या है, ये डबल स्टेज रेगुलेटर है दोनों में, बोथ डबल स्टेज मीन्स एक हमारा क्या है, ये सिलेंडर प्रेशर गेज एंड सिलेंडर प्रेशर गेज एंड वर्किंग प्रेशर गेज. एक्चुअली जब हम लोग वर्क करेंगे, जब जॉब हम लोग स्टार्ट करेंगे, फ्लेम जब बनाएंगे, तो एक्चुअली क्या, वहाँ जो कंज्यूम्ड होगा वो इसमें इंडिकेट करेगा, और जब हम लोग इसको ओपन करेंगे गैस को तो इसमें इंडिकेट करेगा. ओके, तो सिलेंडर प्रेशर गेज एंड वर्किंग प्रेशर गेज. ओके, सेम सिलेंडर प्रेशर गेज एंड वर्किंग प्रेशर गेज. ओके, तो ये भी हो गया सिलेंडर वाल्व, उधर भी ऑक्सीजन का सिलेंडर वाल्व हो गया तुम्हारा, हम लोग का एसिटिलीन सिलेंडर. ओके, मीन्स डीए सिलेंडर भी बोलते हैं, मीन्स डिजॉल्व एसिटिलीन. ओके, नेक्स्ट हो गया हम लोग का ये होस पाइप. होस पाइप कहाँ जा रहा है, ये थ्रू हम लोग का वेल्डिंग टॉर्च में जा रहा है, जब हम लोग वहाँ पर अभी देखेंगे. ये ऑक्सीजन एक्चुअली एसिटिलीन और ऑक्सीजन दोनों जा रहा है, इसमें भी देखो ऑक्सीजन और एसिटिलीन का जो सिलेंडर हम लोग का जो जा रहा है दोनों होस पाइप, वो क्या है, एक का कलर है रेड, एक का है ब्लू. मीन्स ऑक्सीजन का ब्लू और ब्लैक हो सकता है, और एसिटिलीन का क्या है, रेड. जो रेड क्या है, डेंजर. एक्चुअली क्या है, एसिटिलीन जो होता है वो क्या है, फ्लेमेबल गैस है. ओके, एंड ऑक्सीजन क्या है, हेल्पफुल गैस, वो एक्चुअली क्या, बर्निंग में उसको हेल्प करता है. ओके, एंड ऑक्सीजन सिलेंडर पेंटेड आर ब्लू ब्लैक और ब्लैक और एसिटिल सिलेंडर पेंटेड आर मैरून। ओके नेक्स्ट आगे हम लोग और देखते हैं इसमें तो से हॉस पाइप हो गया। नेक्स्ट वेल्डिंग टॉर्च, वेल्डिंग टॉर्च ये टॉर्च बल्ब। ओके ये हो गया टिप। ओके और नोजल मेटल मटेरियल क्या है ये कॉपर। ओके इसमें देखो वन होल है और जब हम लोग इसको अगर गैस कटिंग करते हैं गैस कटिंग में क्या होता है एक फिर वेल्डिंग टॉर्च है और गैस वेल्डिंग गैस कटिंग टॉर्च अगर होने से क्या होता है उसमें फाइव होल होता है मिटल में एक होल रहेगा उसका साइड में और चार पांच होल रहेगा ठीक है जिसमें मिडिल वाले से क्या होता है एक्स्ट्रा एक्सेस ऑक्सीजन जाता है उसमें ठीक है। फिर नेक्स्ट हो गया स्पार्क लाइटर। जब हम लोग इसको बर्निंग करेंगे फ्लेम जब जलाएंगे तो इसको स्पार्क करेंगे देखो इसको बोलते हैं स्पार्क लाइटर। ओके नेक्स्ट वेल्डिंग रॉड और फिलर मटेरियल जिसको हम लोग कहते हैं। चलिए आर्क वेल्डिंग में लोग क्या कर रहे थे इलेक्ट्रोड वेल्डिंग इलेक्ट्रोड यहाँ पर क्या है फिलर रॉड। ओके फिलर मेटल ये क्या है मेटल मटेरियल एमएस माइल्ड स्टील इसके ऊपर क्या है देखो एक लेयर है ये दिखने में लग रहा है क्या कॉपर लेकिन एक्चुअली कॉपर नहीं है एमएस है उसका कोटिंग ऊपर में कोटिंग है जो कोटिंग बोलते हैं सी सी एम एस मीन्स कॉपर कोटेड माइल्ड स्टील। ओके फिर हम जो आफ्टर वेल्डिंग जब जॉब कर लेंगे तो फिर जो सेम प्रोसेस था आर्क वेल्डिंग में कि हॉट मेटल को हम लोग हैंड से टच नहीं करेंगे क्या करेंगे दिस इज द टोंग। ओके एंड इज द चिपिंग हैमर यहाँ पर क्या है हम लोग का कोई एक्चुअली क्या है बेयर बेयर हो गया इलेक्ट्रोड टूटा तो इलेक्ट्रोड मैंने बताया था कि बेयर एंड कोटेड तो कोटिंग अगर रहेगा तो क्या उसमें स्लैग स्लैग आएगा तो स्लैग को हम लोग रिमूव करेंगे तो विदाउट चिपिंग हैमर लेकिन हम लोग गैस वेल्डिंग में क्या होगा कोई स्लैग नहीं आएगा तो यहाँ पर कोई रिमूव नहीं करना स्लैग को हमको ठीक है सिर्फ डायरेक्ट वो डायरेक्ट हो जाएगा क्योंकि बेयर इलेक्ट्रोड में कोई कोटिंग नहीं होता है ठीक है। अभी हम इसको गैस को ओपन करेंगे ठीक है और गैस को बर्निंग करेंगे तो हम लोग यहाँ पर क्या है फ्लेम एक्चुअली हमको क्या करना है फ्लेम फ्लेम का व्हाट इज फ्लेम। ओके तो फ्लेम क्या है फ्लेम क्या एक्चुअली मिक्सचर ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एंड एसिटिलीन। ओके उसको जब मिक्स करेंगे जब बर्निंग करेंगे तो फ्लेम बनेगा तो हम टाइप्स ऑफ फ्लेम थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ फ्लेम फर्स्ट वन इज कार्बोराइजिंग फ्लेम सेकंड न्यूट्रल फ्लेम एंड थर्ड ऑक्सीडाइजिंग फ्लेम। तो हम लोग जब बर्निंग करेंगे तो पहले क्या बनेंगे कार्बोराइजिंग फ्लेम। कार्बोराइजिंग फ्लेम में उसका रेशियो कितना होगा उसका रेशियो होगा 1:2। एक्चुअली क्या है कि कार्बोराइजिंग फ्लेम में क्या होगा कि एक्सेस एसिटिलीन। ओके एक्सेस एसिटिलीन रहेगा तो बर्निंग होगा। नेक्स्ट जो हम लोग बनाएंगे न्यूट्रल फ्लेम उसमें क्या होगा सेम रेशियो ठीक है सेम रेशियो एंड थर्ड जो है ऑक्सीडाइजिंग फ्लेम उसमें क्या होगा 1:2 मीन्स 2 जो है वो रहेगा ऑक्सीजन एंड 1 रहेगा एसिटिलीन। ओके एक्सेस एसिटिलीन चाहिए एक्सेस ऑक्सीजन चाहिए ऑक्सीडाइजिंग फ्लेम में। ओके तो हम इसको बर्निंग करेंगे और वन बाय वन एक एक करके फ्लेम तुम लोग को दिखाएंगे फिर उसको वेल्ड करेंगे ठीक है। यहाँ पर हम लोग का वेल्डिंग जॉब पीस भी है देखो ठीक है इसको हम लोग ऑपरेट करेंगे टॉर्च को। पहले क्या करेंगे जब हम लोग फ्लेम बनाएंगे गैस को ओपन कर देंगे तो हम लोग इसको पहले ओपन करेंगे एसिटिलीन को ठीक है फिर फ्लेम बनाएंगे उसको और एसिटिलीन करेंगे सब बर्निंग करेंगे उसके बाद स्लोली धीरे धीरे हम क्या करेंगे ऑक्सीजन को ओपन करना है तब वो फ्लेम में कन्वर्ट होगा ठीक है। तो ये सारा प्रोसेस दिखाते हैं पहले हम लोग को क्या है गैस सिलेंडर को पहले ओपन करना है फिर वहाँ से फिर यहाँ आएगा टॉर्च में उसके बाद हम लोग इसको फ्लेम बनाएंगे।
So this is your acetylene hose pipe, and this is your oxygen hose pipe. Actually, two gas is coming here separately. Then this is the mixing chamber.
Mixing chamber. Here is mixing chamber.
The mixing chamber. Two gases mixed here. Then and you can regulate the flow of oxygen or acetylene gas here as per your requirement. That means if you want acetylene flame, you can regulate by these two, you can create this. If you can, if you want neutral flame, if you can oxidize, if you want oxidizing flame, so as per your requirement, the ratio can be changed by these two valve. This is acetylene. This is for acetylene gas. This is for oxygen gas. So as per that, as per the ratio, the flame. This is the mixing chamber. Two gases are mixed here, and the combination of these gases are coming from here. Then here you have to make a spark, then flame will create. Okay.
So this valve. Okay.
See the next video. Student, wait 2 minutes.
Okay. Oxygen cylinder thread actually clockwise thread. Okay, means right-handed thread. Okay, and acetylene all thread left-handed. Okay, now I open the cylinder valve anti-clockwise. Okay, anti-clockwise. This is the cylinder key. Same. Open the valve anti-clockwise. And clock, and close the clockwise. Okay. Then next pressure regulator. So हम लोग जाके क्या करेंगे? Increase करेंगे pressure को. Same. Oxygen pressure regulator and acetylene pressure regulator. Okay. अभी हम लोग पॉट को इसको बंद करना है. तो फर्स्ट ओपन द एसिटिलीन वाल्व एंड चेक फ्लो द गैस. ओके. स्टार्ट बर्निंग. नॉट फ्यूम एक्चुअली क्या है कि वहाँ पे फ्यूम नहीं होना चाहिए. फ्यूम पंप को हटा देना है. ठीक है. ये एक्चुअली देखो ये एक्चुअली ज़्यादा अगर खुल गया, ओपन हो गया ऑक्सीजन तो ये बंद हो जाएगा. ठीक है. अगेन स्टार्ट. Okay, burning the gas, acetylene, and slowly oxygen.
So by adjusting these two knob, acetylene knob and oxygen knob, you have to prepare the flame for what you want. So adjusting this, the ratio of flowing these two gases, acetylene and oxygen, you have to make this either acetylene flame or oxidizing flame or neutral flame or carburizing flame. So by regulating these two knobs, you can see sir is doing this by the
carburizing flame.
Now it is carburizing flame.
There are inner cone, inside inner cone.
Look at the flame. Look at the flame. There is an inner cone in this. This is not possible to show the inner cone. And this is the outer envelope.
Inner cone.
This blue section, here is the inner cone. There is a triangular shaped cone is there. Through this camera, this cannot be shown properly. And this is the outer envelope. And the temperature on this region, it will be 3400 degrees centigrade. And on the outer envelope, it is 1250 degrees centigrade. Okay. Here the temperature is like this, and there is more temperature is created there. So that is the inner cone, and this is the outer envelope. And which it is a carburizing flame.
Okay. Excess acetylene. Carburizing flame. Excess acetylene. Okay.
In carburizing frame, amount of acetylene is more than the oxygen. Okay.
Okay. Next neutral flame. Change the ratio.
And then change the ratio. It will. So this is the neutral flame. You can hear roar sound, halka saik roar sound is coming from here. So this is the neutral flame. Here the ratio of oxygen and acetylene is same, okay. And now you will see the oxidizing flame. How it will be?
Neutral flame, amount of gas due to same ratio, 1:1, okay. Oxidizing. Next third now, flame is oxidizing flame. Okay. Change the ratio here.
This roar sound is now more. You can hear the sound. So when the amount of oxygen will be more, then sound will be more. So by hearing this two type of sound, you can identify the either it is oxidizing flame or neutral flame. So now it is oxidizing flame. You can see here, this is the outer envelope, and this is the inner cone is also seen here, this is the outer envelope. So this is oxidizing flame. The amount of oxygen is more in this ratio, okay, than the acetylene. So acetylene is amount of acetylene is less, and amount of oxygen is more here. Okay, and in neutral flame it will be 1:1.
Okay, again change the flame, neutral flame. Okay.
Sir is making neutral flame now again. the sound will, is less here than the oxidizing flame.
Okay, start the weld.
Then how to weld? See attentively. First you have to heat the parent metal. First you have to heat the parent metal.
Preheating process, okay.
This is called preheating process. First you have to heat the parent metal, then with the addition of filler metal, this welding.
Both sides
will be completed.
Both corner tech weld, okay. Tack weld, then
tacking means just ये दो पीस एक दूसरे से हल्का करके ये
temporary joint, tacking process is temporary joint
कि ये दो पीस एक दूसरे से छूट ना जाए. Now this is the actual welding is going on.
Molten metal जब तक यहाँ पिघलेगा नहीं तो हम लोग क्या करेंगे, इसको molten metal जो है देखो अभी एक hole आया, ठीक है. चलो क्या है, ये hole को भी हमको fill करना है.
वो जो गैप है उसको भी फिल करना है विद द हेल्प ऑफ फिलर मेटल. यू कैन सी फर्स्टली सर इज हीटिंग द पैरेंट मेटल, देन
and angle of filler rod is 30 to 40 degree.
Look at the angle.
Okay.
Look at the angle is like this. So angle of this torch will be 60 degree.
60 to 70 degree.
And the angle of filler metal with the base will be 30 degree.
30 to 40 degree.
30
okay.
to 40
degree.
Okay.
Hello.
Complete. The job but joint. Okay.
So you can see
this is the molten metal, okay. Plastic state. Okay.
So this is so the welding is completed.
Welding completed, okay. Done. And close. Okay. Tack weld. Then
tacking means just ये दो पीस एक दूसरे से हल्का.
Okay.
So this is so the welding is completed.
Welding completed. Okay. Done. And close. First is acetylene valve.
First, you have to close the acetylene valve, then oxygen valve.
Next,
because acetylene is a burning gas, acetylene खुद जलता है, और oxygen जलने के लिए help करता है. So you have to first stop the acetylene valve.
And second,
then and secondly oxygen valve.
Okay. And here is close the cylinder.
Now. How to close the cylinder?
Clockwise. पहले हम लोग क्या करेंगे, वहां भी एसिटिलीन वाल्व को मैंने बंद किया और यहां भी हम लोग एसिटिलीन सिलेंडर वाल्व को ही क्लोज करेंगे. ओके, क्लॉकवाइज. Okay.
नो प्रेशर रेगुलेटर इज
प्रेशर रेगुलेटर को भी यहाँ से हम लोग इसको क्लोज कर दिए हैं. एक्चुअली जब क्लॉक वाइज भी ये ओपन हो रहा है और एंटी क्लॉक वाइज भी ये क्लोज हो रहा है. ओके सेम एसिटिलीन को भी करना है. एंटी क्लॉक में ये क्या हुआ, क्लोज हो गया और क्लॉक वाइज में ये ओपन हुआ था. ओके सेम इसका अपोजिट है. ओके थैंक यू.
सो
ओके
ओके स्टूडेंट्स as you have seen that tell me what type of gases are used for this welding.
Sir, acetylene and oxygen.
Acetylene and oxygen. And name the different gases which is which are used for gas welding.
Sir, hydrogen
and okay students, tell me what are the different types of flame produced during gas welding.
So neutral flame,
oxidizing flame, neutral flame and
carburizing flame.
Yes, which flame has a more oxygen?
Sir, oxidizing
flame.
Very good. What are temperature rise between oxidizing flame?
Yes, sir.
What are temperature rise during oxidizing flame? Kitna temperature rise hota hai oxidizing flame mein?
सर 320 to 340.
फिर तो समझ लो कि ये तो हम लोगों का एक एवरेज है जो न्यूट्रल फ्लेम से लेकर के ऑक्सीडाइजिंग फ्लेम तक का होता है.
3400.
Just tell me what is the difference between gas welding and arc welding. Aritra Biswas, boss, Aritra boss. Difference between gas welding and arc welding. Anis Awad. Why are you not responding? Are you there? Aritra. Sweta has left. Students, have you seen this video? Have you learned something?
Yes, sir. Sir, about how to do welding and sir, the process of sir, safety measures to be taken while doing welding.
Okay, so next in class we'll start arc welding. Okay, have you given the attendance?
Sir, in the form, sir, Google form.
Google form. You can also give chat box. Okay, you must give. Everybody will give the your attendance in the chat box. Is there any question, students? After giving the attendance in the chat box, you can leave the class.
Sir, chat box mein question hai.
Achha, dekh rahe hain.
Kaun kaun hai? Nikle class ke kaise?
ओके
okay.
अच्छा सबको तुम लोग ये दे दिए है, क्या बोलता है, लैब रिपोर्ट जमा किए तुम लोग स्टूडेंट्स?
नहीं सर, आप अगले हफ्ते दिए थे तो हम लोग का एक तो हुआ है सर। कहाँ पे जमा करना पड़ेगा सर लैब रिपोर्ट?
ठीक है, हम गूगल क्लासरूम में भेजते हैं, ठीक है लिंक।
ओके सर।
जी सर,
देखते हैं आज भेजेंगे या फिर इसी दरमियान भेजेंगे।
और सर वो वेल्डिंग के टाइम पे वो रॉड 30 डिग्री और 60 डिग्री पे मेंटेन करना जरूरी है क्या?
हाँ वो जरूरी है, इसलिए कि अगर उसका जो है इंक्लिनेशन जरा सा भी कम बेसी होगा ना तो वेल्डिंग में डिफेक्ट आ सकता है।
ओके सर।
तो और उसका रनिंग जो है वो एकदम बेटर होना चाहिए। अच्छा किस किस का तुम लोग आंसर दिए हो, कौन कौन सा लैब रिपोर्ट का स्टूडेंट्स?
सर अभी तक एक भी सबमिट नहीं किए हैं हम लोग।
लिख
कर
ना, मैं यही जानना चाह रहा हूँ, लिख लिए हो ना?
हाँ सर लिख लिए हैं सर, एक लिख लिए हैं, सेकंड वाला लिखना है सर, मोल्डिंग एंड मेकिंग, मोल्ड मेकिंग एंड सर वो वाला।
अच्छा तुम लोग जो किए हो ठीक है, मतलब लिखे हो, क्या वो दिखा सकते हो?
यस सर, एक सेकेंड
देखो। ए संजय शेयरिंग कम कर तो।
सर ये लिखे हैं सर ऐसे।
अच्छा हाँ ठीक है
सर, उसके बाद फिर ये वाला
और फिगर दिखाओ तो, इसमें कौन कौन सा फिगर ड्रॉ किए। वाह बहुत अच्छा है, कितना पेज हुआ टोटल लेकर के?
टोटल 7-6 पेजेस।
6 पेजेस, पेज थोड़ा बढ़ाना होगा समझे, कुछ फिगर देखे इसमें, फिगर वाइस का फिगर बोले तो मैं देने के लिए, हैमर का फिगर बोले तो मैं देने के लिए।
ओके सर
लिखिए, बहुत अच्छा हो ठीक है। ऐसा होगा ना कि मैं इसमें कुछ और क्वेश्चन दूंगा, उसको भी ऐड कर दोगे।
ओके सर।
और फाउंड्री वाला का मैं कुछ स्टडी मटेरियल देखता हूँ, अगर होगा तो भेज दूंगा। ये कहाँ से लिखे थे ये सब?
सर ये हमारे ये जो F2 ग्रुप के है उनसे लेकर लिखे थे, आप बोले तो उनसे लेकर लिख देना तो वही लिख लिया।
हाँ उन लोगों को स्टडी मटेरियल सर मैं सेंड किया था।
हाँ सर, तो आप बोले तो उन्हीं से ले लेना तो उन्हीं से लेकर लिख लिया हम लोग।
अच्छा
अच्छा सर मेरा वाला थोड़ा चेक कर लीजिए।
हाँ देखा, अच्छा ठीक है। ये प्रोसीड्यूर है ना?
क्या हुआ क्या?
हाँ ये वाला प्रोसीड्यूर है ठीक है, ठीक बहुत अच्छा, मार्जिन भी ठीक ही दिए ठीक है। हाँ ठीक, अच्छा बस तुम्हारा तो 5 ही पेज लग रहा है कंचन। कंचन कितना पेज था?
7 सर, 7 पेज।
7 पेज वो इंडेक्स और ये ले करके ना, जॉब शीट
नहीं नहीं सर, इंडेक्स वाला बात देखे, इंडेक्स फिटिंग वो जो आप ये दोनों पेज सर, ये और ये वाला पेज, ये तीनों पेज बात देखे 7 पेज हुआ।
अच्छा अच्छा ठीक है, बहुत अच्छा लिखे। हाँ तो स्टूडेंट्स सभी लिख चुके हो तो देखो यहाँ पर कुछ कुछ दिखा, और कोई लिखा है दिखाओ तो, कंचन और अभिजीत के अलावा। कंचन मंडल, कंचन
विक्रम कुमार ये क्वेश्चन तुम इतना मैं वो तो ग्रुप में शेयर कर दोगे वो भी लिख लेगा तो अच्छे से बोलोगे लिखने के लिए
ओके सर
कुछ हम लोग यहाँ से शेयर कर देंगे हो सकता है जो लिखा हुआ है ना शेयर करेंगे ठीक है
ओके सर
यू कैन लीव
सर अभी तो हम लोग को सिर्फ वेल्डिंग तक की तो जॉब सीट करना पड़ मतलब सबमिट करना होगा तो
हाँ अभी वेल्डिंग तक का ही सबमिट करना होगा
ओके सर थैंक यू सर
कॉल आ रहा है जरा मैं बात करूं।